Dissecting The Song.
And hello, we're live.
Hello, we're good to be back.
We're live.
Huh?
We're live, right?
Yeah, we're live. But actually, we forgot one thing, Hoss.
What did we forget?
Let's see.
And there it is. Okay. We're going to keep this. It's been a bit. Sometimes we don't get to do these as often as we'd like to. We have life responsibilities. We have a channel. I guess this is a sub channel, whatever you want to call it, of comedy. We like to do improv. Yeah, we just off the cuff. We do whatever. It's very completely satire. Don't take anything we do serious.
You guys are subs and we're doms. I think that's
including but not limited to maybe this. So take what we say with a grain of salt. We just interpret songs the way we see fit. Okay.
Yeah, and we like music. We're big fans of music, right?
Yeah, we love music. All kinds of music. I don't think there's a genre that we specifically hate. Screamo is like the only one that I avoid, but I like some screamo. Just not something.
And
I
what's your name? Play.
My name is Jose.
And this is Jose. And this is Dissecting
The Song.
The Song, where we take your music that people submit, right? And we look in between the lines, right, Jose?
Absolutely.
And we do have a playlist. If you guys want to see some other our other stuff, we have a playlist, Dissecting Song. You can check out all the other songs that we've dissected. And this one is from the community that they've been wanting us to do a few more videos on this one, right, Hoss?
Yes, they want us to do Lady Gaga. She has, I don't know if Lady Gaga fans have a nickname, right? Because they have like
maybe Gaga's.
The Beehive for Beyonce. They have Barbies for Nicki Minaj, Swifties for Taylor Swift. But you think the Gagas is the name?
Or like the Gags.
Let us know your names, okay?
Yeah.
The ladies. I don't know.
The LGs.
The LGs.
Couple TVs out there.
Couple electronics roaming around. But we were recommended this by a fan in one of the comments. I don't have the name, so I apologize. So whoever you were, if there's multiple of you, I appreciate it. But this song is about bringing your hands together in a manner in which it emits a sound wave because of the two forces meeting each other, physics. Yeah. Applause, okay?
A force of, what is it?
A force of nature. Nature
meets another object.
Meets the occult power, okay? Yeah. Supernatural powers. But I have heard this song. Have you heard it before?
I've heard, here's the thing with this one. I have heard only the chorus, right? I'm pretty sure it's been like on commercials. Applause.
Yeah, they
applause.
Played at stadiums, I swear, too.
And it was like a Sonic Chevy Cruze. I was like, what the heck? Who wants a Chevy Cruze?
Applause, you know? I've heard this song a couple times for sure. I only recognize the chorus. I wouldn't be able to sing any of the verses. I like this song a lot, at least the sound of it. So we'll see what it tries to tell us. And we'll just get kind of into it. And anytime we want to speak during it, he has to raise his hand. I don't have to. I control the computer. I pause whenever I want to. But I try to be an honest man, so I'll pause it when he needs me to, and I'll pause it when I want to.
And let us know your theory in the comments. If you disagree with us, you know, let us know. You'll probably be wrong, but let us know.
You have any theories going into this? A couple theories. Mine is, this is going to be a self-absorbed song. She wants people to, basically standing ovation anywhere she goes
to worship her, basically
a song.
And here's the thing: she's always doing like religious stuff, because we've done a reaction to Judas and to which one was the other one? Bloody Mary.
Yes.
Bloody Mary. So what I think is probably going to be something like that too, like something religious with you know, her Catholic background. I guess we found out she was raised Catholic, like
for sure
something like that, you know.
Yeah. Okay, we'll get the song going and see how things go. Turn you up on the raise his hand, I have to pause.
Oh, I was gonna applaud.
Oh, okay. I thought you raised your hand out of the corner of my eye.
love this part of the beat.
And the cadence of her, like, how she segments the... I never noticed she spelled it right. I just thought it was like a random word.
Okay, before we go into the next drop, you don't think
so? Don't worry, I'll rewind it. There we go.
So basically, is she talking already? She's talking about drugs, right? Is it like a drug she's talking about? Because she's just something about headed in the vein or something like that.
Yeah.
Like
plus I was thinking of tyranny because we know the Western world doesn't have gongs. Gongs originate in the
Eastern world,
specifically Asian communities.
Yeah.
Where they have the gong, right? It is
the whole family. Usually, they'll
ring it, they'll come for dinner. Yeah. Okay, they'll show up. They know it's dinner time. They know an announcement is always made after the gong is rang, right? It's basically you yell people to be quiet. Something great is about to happen.
Yeah.
So she starts off by ringing the gong, goes into the whole song. And to your point, it might be about drug use.
Yeah, but can you go? Let's dissect those lyrics a little bit because I think
the actual first verse.
Something like that. Well, it was a little bit after the second one. Like she's.
There's a bit of a lag too on this.
There we go. Let's see.
If only fame had an IV, baby, could I bear being away from you? I found the vein, put it in here. She's addicted to the fame.
Oh.
She lives for the applause, but maybe applause is something else that we'll figure out later.
Baby, could I bear being away from you? That is pretty scary, huh? You know what I don't like? Okay, I like about Lady Gaga, but it's not to say I don't like it. It's just like, I personally, we listen to everything predominantly, like the more current stuff we listen to, I would probably say more hip-hop, you know?
Sure.
So sometimes to me, like, this just sounds like background music. To your point, you know?
You don't pay attention to it.
Yes, and then you read this, and you're like, oh, okay. Like it's, and then even when you're like, she's spelling applause. Like to me, that just sounded like a cool part of a beat, like the little,
It is cool, yeah.
But now when you're looking at it, it's like, oh, like, do you, Lady Gaga fans, do you guys actually hear the lyrics? Because I'm not going to lie, like, I don't hear her lyrics unless we're like reading them. I'm like, oh, these are actually, like, she's actually talking.
And we're not knocking on it. Pop music is meant to sound audibly amazing. Mm-hmm. I love pop music, but I don't associate it with deep lyrics as. We've admitted here before. So it's not a knock on her, but it's meant to just be entertaining as opposed to being deep. It's like Shakespeare. No one reads Shakespeare for pure. I mean, some people do. But when you read Shakespeare, you intend to think, oh, it's going to be very meaningful. Whereas when people read Harry Potter, people think more surface level, but she has a lot of symbolism in it too.
Yeah.
So vain, could this be a double entendre of vanity, right? Because if you're waiting for public approval, that is a vain concept. So I found the vein. She found vanity.
Oh,
put it right here.
Put it in here.
Mm-hmm.
That's why she can't be away from it either.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We shall continue.
And she's only said like 6 words so far, and it's like so cool. You know? It's like,
yeah, dude. That is cool. She says a lot with saying.
With a little.
Yeah,
you know?
Just very few words. This chorus is great.
Yeah.
I like the lull in the beat, and then it, like, the drum. It gets faster. Books. One second I'm a coon's man, suddenly the coon's is me. Pop culture was in art, now art and pop culture in me. A memory, applause. Pause it anyways. A pause.
Live for the pause.
I don't even know what coon's is.
I thought that was like a...
Do I need to look it up?
Isn't that like something where they would say like, oh, you're a coon? Wouldn't say that.
Well, I considered that, but that's I don't need.
But that's for the black community.
One second, I'm a coons that suddenly coons is me. Maybe it is like a hold.
Like
please.
A sellout.
Apologies.
It looks like it's like maybe it means like a sellout. You know, like 1 second I'm a coons and suddenly the coons. It's pop culture, like they're pimping it or something, you know? It's almost what we were just talking about, how you're supposed to think that pop is so stupid, right? And it's just like the beat that is supposed to be like superficial, and then it's like...
Oh, Jeff Koons. So he's the guy that did the little balloon animal metallic thing.
Oh,
the dog. I'm guessing. It's the only thing that's coming up when I type in Koons.
It's like his fans?
Yeah. It's basically some sculptor who does a metal, I believe it's metal, sculpture of a balloon dog. I've seen it everywhere. I've seen a lot of... It's pretty cool. I like it. I think it's pretty cool.
So maybe she's saying
one
she's...
One second, like, I'm a Koons, and suddenly the Koons is me. Pop culture wasn't art. Now art's in pop culture in me.
So I guess maybe she's like saying maybe this guy was like the first guy that bent a balloon like that wasn't scared of it to pop.
Sure.
So he's an innovator, right? But then the innovator, now everybody has it. Now even clowns are making balloons.
Yeah.
Right? So now it's like something cheesy. Like now you associate... That guy's like invention, not even an art. Now it's just like, oh, like it's basically, it's so, it's not like a grandiose thing anymore. That it's just like basically, oh, anybody can do it, right?
Yeah.
So now I became that, like something that's so readily available to everything because I basically created something.
Yeah. You know, full circle moment. Pop culture, which is meant for the vast majority, which isn't viewed as artistic, was an art. Because the artist would portray it that way. But now, art is indicative of pop culture.
Now, let me...
In me, which she is right. Pop culture, she is art. She okay. is Lady Gaga.
Okay, get this, okay? Okay? I think you might have just... Now we're getting into the dissection host, okay? Because Koon, what was he getting into? Balloons, yep, right? Balloons. Koon, balloon, it rhymes. And guess what? What happens... I mentioned this earlier inadvertently. What happens when you're trying to make a balloon, right? One of those balloons that you're twisting it's it a
pop.
Little bit. It pops,
pop,
right?
Pop, pop.
Okay. So that guy, balloon makers are in pop culture, right? Because a lot of balloons probably pop. So balloons are popping, right? It's like in their culture. It's like, dude, this is like... So maybe she's saying that she used to be a balloon artist. And that's like the pop culture she was into balloon making with the Koons, right?
Okay, that makes
sense. But then Big Pop, you know, Big Pop came over. They took over, right? Now yeah. They say, oh, pop culture is music is going to be what's in. So now like the pop culture like with the Koons where they're popping balloons and stuff, now that's been ruined obsolete and she's in a different demographic now.
Nice. Okay, sounds good. I have to agree. People say kick rocks, kick pops, okay? Yeah. Come
rock
on.
Pops.
Rock pops. I hope we get a third verse. I don't know if there is. I can't remember. Really good song. Pop has lost its appeal. Like this is pinnacle pop. There's a lot of them, but...
Hey, pee-pee.
Put your hands up, make them touch. How do people pop balloons?
Okay.
They clap and smack them.
They clap and smack them.
Until they pop.
Now, to your point, Hoss, right? Now, what are they doing when she's giving you the directions on how to make a Koon.
Make a scene.
Yeah, and make one of those balloon artifacts.
Give me that thing I love. I'll turn the lights out. Because you should have it memorized. You should not be able to see it.
So she's telling you how to do it. Put your hands up.
It's like Stevie Wonder tying a tie. You think Stevie Wonder needs lights to tie a tie?
Exactly.
Absolutely not. He doesn't need it.
Make the ends touch. So you grab both sides of the balloon.
And bend it together.
Bend it together. You start wrapping it.
Make them touch. Touch.
Yes.
Okay.
I live for the applause.
pop.
Art pops.
See, put
right?
your, put your hands up, make them touch. Triple entendre, perhaps, right? She is art. She is pop. She is the balloon.
Yes.
Make her pop. Make
and
her
that'll
art.
That'll take her to.
Yep.
Oh, a Pop-Tart, right? And that is food that you can digest.
For
it's
nutrients.
A sustenance.
For nutrients like vitamins, minerals, yeah. energy, carbohydrates, all of the
yes.
above.
And it has a long shelf life, just like Lady Gaga. A Pop-Tart, how long does it last?
So long. It's preservatives. Exactly. And when you consume preservatives, you preserve your own life. You preserve your own pop culture. You preserve art.
Yes. And now to going back to where she was talking about the veins, right?
Yep.
Like she's... So she's part of the community. She wants... Go back to that lyric again. Sorry, host, at the beginning where it was... she basically said she can shoot it up, right? Like she's...
She found vein, put it in me. Put it in here. If only fame had an IV, baby, I could bear being away from... Could I be bear being away from you? I found the vein, put it in here. She doesn't want to let it go.
Yeah.
If fame had an IV... She could keep it alive. Maybe she's saying she's the nutrients that fame
she's
needs.
She's the sustenance for it.
Yep.
Yeah, cause
she doesn't need the fame. Fame needs her.
Needs her, exactly.
Yep.
You know, so it's almost even full circle. Balloons are the shape of a circle usually, right?
Yep, full circle.
So, yeah, I think that's, I think we hit it right there on the, right on the nose, right on the hands. You know
right on
mean?
The hands. Put them up and make them touch, guys.
So she's describing herself as like a quadruple. Did she do a quintuplet, maybe?
Quintuplet entendre. First ever.
First ever.
First ever quintuple entendre.
Because she's talking about balloon, pop.
Art.
Pop is her. Art is her. She's keeping art alive.
Yep.
Because she's like, if I'm so addicted, how did I become... She also, like, if we're talking about drugs, she became the drug at the end, right?
Yes.
So it's like she's so big that he's like, okay, I used to be addicted to the drug, but now... I'm the drug. So how do I even find pleasure now that I'm the drug? Like, how do you even find any thrill or
Correct.
Anything like that?
Mm-hmm.
When it's just like, yeah, you now it's up to you guys to keep me alive because I don't run on anything else.
Yep.
You know?
Incredible.
Yeah, that was pretty good.
Well, you let us know what you know or what you think you know.
Yeah, or if you guys think we're wrong. I think we nailed it. You don't think so?
I feel
pretty
like
good.
We nailed it, yeah.
I'm always scared to dissect the Lady Gaga songs, you know? People will be like, oh, you know, this meant this, and they'll tell us.
Oh, you got it so wrong.
Yeah, and it's like, dude, we're trying our best. She's hard to the.
Yeah.
Yeah.
She's too smart for us.
Too smart for us, you know?
But anyways, we appreciate you tuning in.
Yep.
Go ahead and sub. We appreciate the comments. We'll be reviewing more as time goes by. Again, we're looking through the comments to see what you guys want us to review.
Yeah.
And we'll try to comply as much as we can. But thank you for tuning in. To Dissecting the Song. We'll
that
catch
was
you.
Jose.
Yeah. Sorry. My name is Jose.
And this is Jose. You guys have a good one.